We find ourselves at the home of the world's first retractable natural grass field as you get a look inside University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the New York Jets and the Arizona Cardinals. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. First carry now. This is Johnson. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. The Charles David Johnson, a great start to the season. Week 5 was his best outing so far.
It truly was. We watch all the aspects of his game that make him what he is, which I think is a great running back. But the biggest one that's maybe underestimated is the chip on his shoulder. Not recruited heavily out of high school. Smaller college, not taking this seriously coming into the pros, and he wants to prove everyone wrong with every carry.
157 yards, 2 touchdowns in that win against San Fran.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those 3 guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up 4th. Now the punter, Ryan Quigley, is on in his 4th season out of Boston College. This is taken at about the 14. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Jets take possession.
Brandon, when a team is struggling, turning and leaning on your defense is usually a pretty good idea. And for Arizona, it was gold against the San Francisco 49ers. They just swarmed them the entire night.
2 interceptions, a bevy of sacks. Really nice job. And if they come into form, maybe this Arizona team can get back on the right track.
And they got Calais Campbell going on the defensive line and Marcus Golden off the edge. He was nails.
First down, Fitzpatrick. Wide open, it's Marshall complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. While the Jets offense struggled against the Steelers, Brandon Marshall didn't struggle. His best game of the year, over 100 yards and a touchdown grab.
One of the best things I've always liked about Brandon Marshall's game is that there's no back down in it. It doesn't matter what you throw at him, he believes he can defeat that coverage and make big plays for his team, and he did again against the Steelers.
Fitzpatrick on first down. And complete over the middle, Safarian Jenkins. 12 yards on the pickup, and the Jets are going to have a first down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
A first down throw for Fitzpatrick. A dump off to Forte. They'll give him 8 on the play, and it'll make it 2nd down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
To the air again, Fitzpatrick. It's caught by Quincy Anunua, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
First carry for Matt Forte. Nice, showed a little athletic juke, but then the daylight quickly closed. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. So the carry that time for Forte, a man who turned 30 last December, Charles.
And he wants to make sure we forget about that with his new team, the New York Jets. But we do know that 30 is the dreaded age for runners.
And Forte, so experienced, more touches than anybody else in the NFL the last 8 years. Now a second down throw for Fitzpatrick. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went three and out.
And now to have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. On second down, here's Palmer. It's caught left side by John Brown. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football, and they've got it here with a first down. Palmer gives to Johnson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 11 yards on the pickup, and the Cards are going to have a first down.
Have you talked with your friends who are in the fantasy leagues? I keep hearing David Johnson's name is coming up in a big way.
Boy, he was a steal third-rounder out of Northern Iowa, and I think last year started as a fourth-string back, didn't he?
He certainly did, but boy, he produces the year one on. Remember, he can run it, he can catch it. He was a wide receiver at Northern Iowa before he became a running back and also has great kick return ability. Ran one back for a touchdown in 2015.
That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. And now it's third down and inches. Try and run for it. Here's Johnson. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
So it'll be first down here after the run. They go play action here on first down, finding time. Looking for Fitzgerald, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the great one, Darrell Revis. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And New York set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive, and then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Second down, Fitzpatrick. Drops it underneath to Forte. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and they're going to have a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Third down and three. Right. from the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. And he's got a man open. That's Marshall. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. On first and 10, Fitzpatrick backing up. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. You know, each week you and I have gone around, discussed a different division. The NFC West, that's pretty intriguing right now, isn't it?
Well, when the season began, I think most of us thought it was a two-way race. Arizona and Seattle. And really no one else was mentioned. Now, I think it's a three-way race. Obviously, Los Angeles, not too great on offense thus far, but their defense keeps them in and has them win a lot of games. Remember, they've already beaten Arizona and Seattle.
Give him six on the play, and it'll be third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Again, it's Fitzpatrick. And that's complete to Marshall on the crossing route. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. So he makes the grab, and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
Fitzpatrick on first down. Peek's got it over the middle. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Seven yards to go on second down. Now whistles come in before the snap. Looked like one of the Jets may have moved. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. To the air again, Fitzpatrick. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So here we go, first and 10 now. Fitzpatrick down, a throw on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Kevin Minter in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Now a second down throw for Fitzpatrick. Throws left side complete to Brandon Marshall. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Now is Nick Folk in the field goal unit for the Jets. From the left hash, this from 37. And the former Arizona Wildcat, Folk, gets this one to go. And the Jets hit the board first. It's 3-0. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
After the made field goal, back out is Nick Folk to kick this one off. Now it's Ellington to return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Gilchrist. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. So out now come the Jets. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
Looking for Marshall, but it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people would think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. 1-18. Now Palmer to throw on 2nd down. Over the middle here to Brown. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll lead here to a 3rd down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it, because you're running away from people on it.
And they're just a couple of yards shy of a 1st down here on 3rd down. Third and two, now Palmer, and he's got Gresham. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. The 1st down carry here for Johnson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
They come up in an offset eye. On 2nd down, Palmer. And Gresham's got it over the middle. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Jermaine Gresham. 26 yards. And the Cardinals have retaken the lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails? Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Anunua's got it, complete. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 12. That's good for a Jets first down.
Well, they obviously, red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think. What do you mean by that?
He made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and he curls back inside for the completion.
Fitzpatrick on first down. And that will be caught, but out of bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete here. Now, you know, partner, while we have a second, we went into last week, week five, with three unbeatens. We left with one, the Minnesota Vikings.
It's a tough league, and you never know what you're going to run into. Denver, they were surprised at home by Atlanta. How about Philadelphia on the road at Detroit, who was 1-3 at the time? And Minnesota keeps rolling along. They thumped Houston. And a lot of people are giving a lot of credit to that brand new state.
They've got his man complete. That one goes for 24 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Surveying the field. All kinds of time. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Again, they were targeting Marshall there, and it's second down.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Off the draw from Fitzpatrick, it's Forte. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And that was a big-time play by the defense because everything was set up for the offense to be successful. Nickel package, you run the draw, you expect to get a big guy out in space on a smaller defensive back to block him. That didn't happen on this play.
Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale. It's Jet football, but they trail here as we start the fourth quarter. An extra DB added here for the Cards on third.
Blitz of play coverage.
From the gun, Fitzpatrick. He's got time. Still back there. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Whether they deserve credit or not, the defense is going to take credit for that incompletion because it always feels good when you slow down an offense.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Three down, three down.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's got time in the pocket. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones up to determine runner.
And on this challenge, the refs have to take a peek and see whether or not the receiver was able to dot the I with both feet,
while making sure that he possesses the football all the way through the catch.
Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. First down. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Second down, Johnson, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a third and four. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set as they try to stop this third down. Sack. They push him back to the 34. They bring a man off the corner that time, and he gets home for a loss of six.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You're able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
Now after the made field goal, Catanzaro to boot this one away on the kickoff. This fielded at the two. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Jet offense now. They head out to take over. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
18 yards on the pickup there. And it's good for a New York first down. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, he was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch, maybe you move some motion, maybe you put them on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, they figure a way to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open. And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense. Throwing again here, Fitzpatrick on second and 10. Throws left side, complete to Brandon Marshall. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football. First down, Fitzpatrick. Caught, Seferian Jenkins, right side. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It's a gain of 5, and that'll make this a second down. They'll throw again, Fitzpatrick. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Back to throw. Deep drop. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Marshall, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Forte, the lone running back. He'll get the football here. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a 3rd and 1. And now they're in the hurry up. He's back to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal. Back to throw. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Quincy Anunua, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
Love the excitement we've got going here. They just scored the touchdown. They're down by 1. How much fun is it now to figure out the possibilities? Kick the extra point and tie it. Go for 2 if they're really feeling in a gambling mood. What do you do in this situation?
I think you kick the PAT.
Yeah, I do too. Kick it, get my defense ready, and try and stop them one more time.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And last year that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. So out now come the Cardinals. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target, and that'll make it 3rd down. Defense has set themselves up nicely. 3rd and 10 now. Now it's Palmer. He hits Floyd on the right. Now the Jets are going to burn another timeout. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And now out come the Jets. They need to get this around the 40 on the other side to get into field goal range. Look at the clock, a decent amount of time here in a tie game. What do?
No panic situation at all. They've got to get a couple of chunk plays, pick up nice bits of yardage.
Target the sidelines.
Target the sidelines because you want to get out of bounds and make sure that clock stops. Because if the clock stays running, that makes things that much tougher for you. It can always bleed out on you.
A dump off to Forte. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Call it a gain of five. And it'll bring up a second down. And they're going to speed things up here. Now Fitzpatrick drops it underneath to Forte. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Fitzpatrick to throw. Finding time. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Here's Fitzpatrick. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Give him seven on the play, and that'll make it third down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So here now is the kicker. And now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So here now is the kicker, Nick Folk. This from long, very long range. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. And that changes everything here in OT. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Five receivers in the game, four of them to the left side. On first and 10, Fitzpatrick throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
Fitzpatrick toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. They were looking for Marshall that time. That'll bring up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
So here's third and 20, and with a long yardage, defense going with a nickel look. To throw is Fitzpatrick, surveying the field. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's brought down after a good gain. It's a big play that time by the Jets. 31 yards.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Fitzpatrick now to throw on first down. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
On second down, Fitzpatrick again to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay inbounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. Here's Lachlan Edwards now. On for a very important punt here in overtime. And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And the Cardinals' offense here ready to take over. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Yeah, part one is done, now part two. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. Johnson on his way, 20, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner in OT. Well, you never know what you're going to expect when you come to the stadium to call a game. Sometimes you get good ones, sometimes you get bad ones, sometimes you get great ones.